Hi, I'm Jack Horton, and I'm an ESRI instructor. I'd like to show you the ground-to-grid transformation in ArcGIS Pro. This works in a parcel fabric or just with any features. Ground-to-grid transformation is all about rotation due to the map projection and perhaps due to just rotation in your data that came from the basis of bearing or your survey. And also scaling, which is due to the elevation and the map projection. Together, those give you scaling. It's called the combined factor. The combined factor, in addition to the rotation, is referred to as the ground-to-grid correction. So let's go ahead and show you how that works. Now, I'd like to point out that we have a center line here. And that thing is really close to north-south, right? It's almost perfectly north-south. In fact, let's go ahead and cogo that in. And I'll set the start location right here. And I'll just read it off of here on the plat. It looks like that's 0 degrees, 3 minutes, which is almost north-south, 30 seconds. And it's in quadrant 4. And it looks like it's 250 feet. Okay, now notice I laid in this blue line right here, which is not lining up on the center line. It is, however, lining up very nicely on the edge of the map because it's almost perfectly north-south. So I need it to rotate with the rest of the map as I do my work. So let's fix that, and I'll undo the change that I made here in the traverse. And let's undo again. And now let's set the ground to grid transformation. I can do it either up here or down here. And when you're doing this, make sure you have snapping turned on because you want to be precise. So I'll right click, and I could provide a direction offset and a distance scale factor if I knew them, but I don't. So instead, I'll figure it out from the map. I'll enter the ground line and draw the grid line. So I need to enter the ground line parameters, and it'll be asking me to enter a bearing and a distance. So it looks like I've done this before, so I can not have to type it in. And notice this line here has the bearing and distance that is here. So I'll use this line going from precisely between these points in order to set it. Now, ideally, these would be control points and be even more accurate. I'll just hit next, and I will now go ahead and draw in the grid line so it can compare what I digitized here against what I typed in. And when it did that, it got a rotation of about 1.9 degrees and a scale factor very close to 1. So let's test that out now. Let's go ahead and do the same traverse we did before. And that would be 0-3-30 in the fourth quadrant, which is going to be northwest. And the distance is 250. And it lays in a line that should line up real well with the plat. Now, let me turn that plat off so you can actually see what's underneath it. And sure enough, the line I put in was right underneath it, and you couldn't see it with the plat turned on. So that caused it to rotate and scale and very nicely fit the map, so that even though the map is rotated, we can enter precise survey COGO and have it line up correctly. All right, so that is the ground-to-grid transformation. That's how to set it, and that's what it's about. You can use it with a parcel fabric, or you can use it with any data entry you need to in ArcGIS Pro. All right, thank you.